Hello everyone, this is Abdu Alkishe, postdoctoral at Fish and Wildlife Conservation, Virginia Tech. Today I'm going to talk about ecological niche modeling algorithms. So model algorithm refers to the procedure, rule, or mathematical function used to estimate the species ecological niche as a function of a suite of environmental variables. So based on the type of input data, we have three approaches. The first one is presence only approaches, which is relying on presence records. The second one, presence absence approaches, and this one using background or pseudo absence data. The third one is presence background approaches. So for the first one, presence only approaches, in some approaches rely on presence record without need for reference to other samples or any other information drawn from the study area. So here the example of the algorithm is Maxent, and this algorithm based on logistic-like regressions comparing densities of presence points and densities of random points, which is here the background, and using continuous environmental variables with diverse sets of parameters in the calibration process. For the presence absence approach, some algorithms function by contrasting sites at which the species has been detected with sites where the species has been documented as absent, and therefore require both presence and absence data. And here we have two examples, including regression, for example, generalized linear models and generalized additive models. The other one is a classification, for example, posted regression trees, random forest, and support vector machines. So those are the most common algorithms that we use, presence absence data. For the presence background approaches, these approaches assess how the environment where the species is known to occur relates to the environment across the entire study area, which uses the background in this case. And the example is very similar to the previous one, using classification algorithms. And there are popular algorithms that we use in ecological niche modeling. The most important and common one that we used with just presence only data, which is maximum entropy, and it's widely used algorithm, and it estimates species distribution by maximizing entropy while incorporating constraints based on environmental variables. This algorithm has been successful in predicting species distribution using presence only data. The next one is the random forest. This is a machine learning algorithm that uses a sample of decision trees to model species distribution, and it's known as its ability to handle complex interactions between environmental variables, and has been used in ecological niche modeling to predict species distribution. Generalized linear models. This algorithm is statistical models that relate species occurrence to environmental variables. And it's very widely used in ecological niche modeling because of their interpretability and ability to handle different type of response variables, such as presence, absence, or presence-only data. Posted regression tree. Here is an ensemble modeling technique that combines multiple decision trees through posting, and it's particularly useful for handling nonlinear relationships between species occurrences and environmental variables. The last one is support vector machine. And this one is a machine learning algorithm, can map data points to higher dimensional space and separates them into different classes using hyperplans. It's been used in ecological niche modeling to use predict or to predict species distribution on presence absence data. So those are some examples, and those are the most common algorithms that we use in ecological niche modeling. There are many others, but they are not like common as those ones. Thank you so much for your listening.